Time has different dimensions. Like in music, different time signatures. Nothing travels faster than light. And anything that comes close to it is controlled by the laws of the universe, making sure that it does it. So when we close our eyes, it's like we're changing time signatures, as our thoughts are tiny specks of light. And this is why we never feel like we've been sleeping for 8 hours when we wake up. Because when we close our eyes, we're really time traveling.
From the lion's den, his environment violent. It surrounds him, he drowns in the sirens. The lights are blinding, and so his mind is constantly inquiring as to why he admires them. Still, it inspires him. He pays till he's tired, then he retires and goes back to Leviathan. This is his private world, he has designed it to be timeless, his own tiny island. Flew up the fire and didn't like what he saw, the flaws, so he'll change it as he desires it. These are his diamonds that he provides him with to hopefully guide them. The drums that live inside of him, the guitars and the keys and then the violins. These are the colors he uses to break the silence. Ignorance he will find and rewire it. The architect of a marvelous world, I am him.
I don't know the trigger, but I can't remember back to a feeling of loving.
Maybe there is some evil.
Scared? Why should I go about living life in a negative scare?
If this doesn't stop, it's going to become a civil war.
The things that people want us to listen to are just, you know, not good.
Everything is there.
It's a beautiful world.
There's a disconnect.
I've seen so many here that wasted everything.
If they'll listen.
Twists and turns, beautiful as it glows, while it comes to a close. And he's scared cause he knows, but he just can't let go of the hope that he holds in his heart. He creates it and pulls it apart, then rebuilds it again till it's perfect. His work is never done, the excellence is under the surface. Light that he sees at night when he dreams, magnificent colors that reflect from the beams. He doesn't know what it means and he's caught in between. Purgatory, the warrior will fight till he bleeds. He won't go quietly, he won't die on his knees. He will stand as a man for his life he believes. And so tightly he'll squeeze if he's right or he's wrong. He'll hold on till it's gone, till it rusts in its dust. And he wakes up, takes a hold of his pen like it never happened. And he just
societies don't change. Whether it was the Roman Empire or Nazi Germany, population is obsessed with sports and petty celebrities.
That's where the real problem lies. That's the root of our problem.
When you can flip from channel to channel on the news and on dramas and on every other program, and all it is brainwashing and demonization,
and you become a slave, you become a servant. These people, that's their goal, that's their intention.
They couldn't get away with this if the public wasn't so dumb.
Become the best individuals we can be to fulfill our God-given potential.
We are smashing these people. We are exposing them at every level, and they know it, and they can't stand it.
The thing is, we have one advantage, that they need us to cooperate. See, if they don't cooperate with them, they can't win. And once we learn not to cooperate with them, then we win the game. And that's the point. Don't cooperate with them. Don't go along with the program. Stop it.
My friends, we've got to set our priorities and set them now. Liberty or tyranny?
There has to be an uprising. People have to stand up. I can't do it alone.
I'm not like you. I didn't sell out.
I get nervous about what I do, but I do it because there's no other choice. You know, I couldn't live with myself if I didn't do it.